Hello, I'm Paddy from creativemedia.org.uk. I'm kind of doing this backwards because start from the start again. This is a stick blender with one of these things on, and it, some stage, just started kind of turning off and turning on a bit randomly. I need to shake it around a bit. Yeah, if I held the button down, shook it around, it would turn on and off, and eventually it just stopped starting altogether. So, I kind of diagnosed that as being the brushes on the motor. And of course, they're well inside this, and it's quite grubby, this. There's no sign of how to get into this at all. But thanks to a bit of a video on YouTube and a bit of messing around myself, I've got it working again. A secret to get into it. I've scraped around this join here quite a bit with a sharp screwdriver. And then the secret was to just bash it round and round. Same technique for coconuts, actually. Just get bashing, and eventually these two halves sprang apart, which is rather good. I don't actually need to do anything to this back bit. If it's all stayed intact, you can leave that as it is. If you do need to get into this part, like for instance, if you can't get this to go back in properly, you lever the rubbery plastic off, start somewhere or other. Possibly here is a good place to start. And gradually this bit will just come off. It's off the bits, off the other hard plastic. And inside here is a circuit board. And usual trick here, just check that you've got the plug to the unit in your hand before you start prodding the insides, otherwise you can get shocks. The edges of this circuit board have some contacts on, which line up with these bits here. They just slot in to there. So that should be fairly easy to get back together. Important thing not to do is to start twisting this and the motor. I'll zoom out a little bit. Whoop, that way, yeah. Yeah, don't twist that. But if you do twist the two, why don't you want to twist them? Because then it won't line up properly. If you do twist them, there's a convenient notch and slot, which I'll mention later, inside here, which you can actually feel when it's in the right position, it should clonk into that. But if you do twist it as well, it's a lot harder to get this bit off. And to get this off, the way I did it was I removed this plastic piece, which just comes off with just springs off, so that's quite easy. Put this in the vise and just kind of banged away at this bit so it came off. You might be able to pull it as well, but it's quite a tight fit. I'm going to have to take this off again because I'm actually putting it back together at the moment, having actually checked that my fix worked. But I've got to put in this rubber seal, which I left out rather stupidly. So I'll do that. I should say, when you are removing this plastic bit, make some kind of mark to make sure you get it the right way around. This one here has a 1 written on it there, kind of embossed in the plastic. So I've made a pencil mark down there. Very subtle, but it'll do for me, to make sure that the 1 is close to that pencil mark. Then you'll make sure that the motor turns around the right way. I think I'll mention that again later, but I'm doing this backwards, so I've mentioned it before. It's very confusing, this. Well, here I am with the motor from the inside of the stick blender. I can leave this bit on. I can remove that if I need to, but I don't think I do right now. You can see there's a washer is sticking to the magnets inside the motor. To get in, I had to bend back 8, possibly, bits of these metal. And this is quite thick metal, so I had to tap it with a sort of stonework chisel. Seemed the easiest thing to use. Put this in the vise and tapped away. And then this plastic bit comes out. This is a bit where all the problem is. I'll point with a screwdriver. Yeah, so this side This is a brush which brushes against the motor windings and carries a charge from these bits, which I guess connect to these bits, onto the motor, and it spins around. But this side is really worn down in comparison, and that is no longer making an electrical connection, which is why the motor doesn't turn on. And it's why it does turn on when I give it a shake or a bang. That kind of shakes it enough to make that connect briefly. It'll turn around a bit and then stop again. So I need to get this stuff out, which may be interesting. And then I have ordered some blocks, which I think are identical fit. Got those from eBay. They come in packs of 9, I think. So I've got 9 of them. So I'm going to try and get that one in to replace the one that's worn down. Weirdly, and this seems to happen a lot in motors, this side hasn't worn down much. This side's worn down a lot. Why is that? Who knows? So I'm going to try a bit of levering or something to see if this will kind of pop out in an easy way. But I think it's probably going to involve some pliers and kind of scrunching it up a bit. Ooh, that bends. That's useful. I think my scrunching idea is something I'm going to try. So I'm going to use some pliers and try and just scrunch this thing up and replace it. Ooh, yeah. So that bit of... where are we? That bit of scrunching has made a nice gap there. So I'm hoping that the new one will slot into this hole. I can't see it at the same time as you can. That's probably it. Yeah. It might just click in. It might just. So, I mean, it's me to make sure I'm going in the right way. So it's kind of upright like that. Let's see if this fits. He might have gone in. Ah, no, not properly. Gone half in. Okay, that looks like it's in. So, here is my secret tip, which seems to have worked. You get your pliers, put them either side of the of where the block's going to go in, and then push against that. Then you should be able to push it in more easily. So you can see that at all. I don't know if that's any help at all, but yeah, that worked just now. And I think that's still intact. So, fingers crossed, I should be able to put that back into the motor. And here's the inside of the motor. And this is the bit where my brushes do all their brushing. They brush against this bit here. And lining up this plastic bit with this motor isn't actually all that hard, not in the stick blender, because there's one of these sticky outy bits, there must be proper names for these, is a bit narrower than the others, and that lines up with that sticky inny bit. I really should learn some engineering language, shouldn't I? So, if that lines up with that, but of course, I'm not sure whether the brushes are going to fit around. I may need to push that brush out a bit through there whilst I push the top on. Okay, that's together now. That took a bit of a longer time than I thought. So all these plastic bits are kind of slotted into the slots on the motor housing, as expected. That is spinning. It's making a bit of a noise, but hopefully that's okay. Where's that one go? So now I'll reverse the process of taking it apart and see whether it actually fires up at all or whether that was a total waste of time and money. I'm using a hammer to do some very gentle tapping just to get the metal plate back on properly onto the back of the motor. That should do. And now I'll need to bend these corner bits back somehow. Maybe some pliers might do it, but I think those won't be strong enough. So I think I'll have to go out and use a chisel. They're lugs, aren't they? I think those lugs or those edge bits, I've bent them back in, and I used this chisel, which is actually one I made in a metalwork class nearly 40 years ago. And back then it got quite bad marks because it wasn't very good, but I reckon I'm probably one of the few people, I've got PU, my initials on it. I'm probably one of the very few people from that class that still has this and is still using it, I think. So, Mr. Povey, if you're still alive, you'll be pleased to hear that my kind of grade D chisel is still in use. Now here's where I'm glad that I marked the motor and this plastic connector bit to make sure the positive and negative terminals match up with the right sides. I don't know if it would just go backwards if they were matched up wrongly or whether it would actually wreck the motor entirely, but having it right is good because maybe there's good reasons why you wouldn't want your blender thing to go backwards. Yeah, of course there are, because the blade is sharp one side and not the other side. So getting that right is quite important. Something I didn't mark for putting it back together is this metal sleeve. But it does have a notch in here. And this motor has a notch in there, and I reckon those two line up. So I'm going to put that there. That seems to fit quite nicely. I mean, this bit is always quite loose. I'm not really quite sure what it does, whether it's some vitally important safety feature or just something to fill the gap, stop it rattling. Who knows? Right, I've slotted it together. This is very loose. I just pushed it together, and the mains is on, so I'm not going to pull this apart. Even though the mains is kind of in a board here and probably not too risky. Dry hands as well. Less chance of shocks. Right, so press the button. Let's see what happens. Wow! It actually works. Both speeds. And hopefully if I shake it a bit, it still works. So that's the turny bit turning round, the turny bit. Okay, that's really amazing. That's the first time I've replaced a brush in anything. I'm going to unplug it now before I pull it apart. And that fix cost me something like £4 or £5, I think, for those brushes, which I've already lost. So I'm going to put them. Anyway, even if it was just for one brush, that £4 or £5, there they are. So in theory, I could fix eight more of these with the brush problems. And also these brushes potentially could be filed into different shapes for other bits of equipment. But even if I throw these away, all I've wasted is these bits. Rather than wasting this, and this, and this, and this whole spinny thing, chopping up gadget, I'd have had to get rid of these because there'd be nothing else that was compatible with them. And we'd have had to get a whole new thing made. And somebody did point out to me that you can buy a new stick blender for £7.95 or something at Tesco's, but this is quite a good stick blender, and it's working again now, and I've not wasted lots of materials, and I'm not throwing away any of this. Not for a while, I hope. So, results? Okay, I've got choices for putting this back together. I could try a bit of super glue. I suspect if I need to change the brushes again, it'd be really hard to undo that. So instead, I'm going to try using some glue stick. Now, I don't have a glue gun. I just find them a pain. So I just use a little torch here. This is one of my top tips. And melt that a little bit. And I could just going to slightly pull this apart. Not pull it so far apart that the contacts uncontact themselves. But if I can just dab a few bits of that in there. And elsewhere maybe as well. And then just push it together. And I can use this as a kind of seal. Hopefully, if I ever need to get it apart again, maybe apply a tiny bit of heat from the gun like this, you know, from a distance, not too close. That might get it apart again. But hopefully it'll be strong enough to seal the thing. Almost like drawing with a really soft crayon around the join. I'm just going to apply a tiny bit of heat from a distance right around and try and press that in, but try not to actually set light to my blender. Okay, hopefully this won't burn my fingers. Hopefully that will stay together. I don't think it's going to be properly waterproof though. So I have to be a bit cautious using this. And not so well, I wasn't going to ever put it in the water anyway. It's not watertight. But I have to be extra careful. Now I'm going to check if it still works. Because, oh dear, look at the difference in cleanliness between this bit and this bit. I don't use the whisk very much. But yeah, it's always depressing when you finish a job, you think it's working, and then you glue it all together, and then you find that something's gone wrong. So let's check that. Yay! I am as pleased as punch with that. I'm so pleased. So yeah, fixing makes you feel good. So if you want to fix a stick blender, that might help you. Thanks for watching.